All right, so before we say how do you overcome procrastination, we have to start at the root and understand why. Because you guys know that I always want you guys to understand the root so that you don't have to deal with the same thing over and over again. So how do you overcome procrastination? Start with the root, right? And understand, okay, why is this procrastination here? Most times, fear disguises itself as procrastination. You might have a fear of something. So there's fear disguises it in many different ways. I have a post on that on my page. But you might find yourself having a fear of the fact that this is a new space for you and you actually don't know much about it. So you might find yourself procrastinating because you're scared of messing up. You might find yourself procrastinating because you're scared of failure. You might find yourself procrastinating. Difficult word to keep saying, but you might find yourself procrastinating because you simply are just too scared of failing up, because you have self-doubt from past experiences, or because you're projecting past experiences into the future. So the fear that you might have is what's causing you to procrastinate, and it's okay for you to acknowledge that fear. Acknowledge that you might not know what it is that you need to do, because your solution will be to ask other people how to do it, to ask for help, to get the help that you need. But you can't do that without acknowledging why you've been procrastinating and why it is that you've been letting off on this thing that you need to do. Because if it's going to serve your higher purpose and if it's going to serve your vision, you might actually put some effort into it. But first start with the why. If you have self-doubt, then you need to reaffirm yourself into actually getting over it. Now that you're aware that this procrastination comes from fear, you need to forgive yourself for having the procrastination, or for not prioritizing yourself, not prioritizing your goals, not prioritizing your vision. Forgive yourself for any resentment, shame, right? Because a lot of times when we experience procrastination, or when we create these circumstances where we're not doing what we need to do, or what we want to do, or what we have to do, or what we choose to do, is mainly because we are hard on ourselves, right? So forgive yourself for all the shame that you've given yourself. I know a lot of people use negative self-talk, like I'm a loser because I haven't done this. This means that I'm never going to achieve anything in life. And that's not true, right? So forgive yourself for all the resentment, guilt, shame that you have given to yourself and think other people are looking at you with, which might not even be the case. All right. The next part is create your schedule. Now that you've acknowledged the root of it, now that you've forgiven yourself, moving forward, what do you need to do, right? So ask yourself, what is it that I need to give myself permission to do? The next thing that you need to do is that you actually, now that you've acknowledged the fear, now that you've acknowledged the reason as to why you've had this procrastination, now that you've acknowledged that you're actually scared, that you've been nervous about going through a pandemic, now that you've acknowledged all that fear, and you've also forgiven yourself, now you need to get to the practical part of things, right? So what is it that you need to do now is that you maybe need to set routines or set a schedule for yourself so that you can actually create the time space for you to achieve the things that you want to achieve. So remember that when you're setting a routine, your goal needs to be very realistic in terms of the routine that you're setting, right? Don't set yourself up by overcommitting, and also ask for help where you actually need help or where you don't understand certain things. Whether this is a job oriented thing or a project of your own, there's always somebody that you can think of. When I speak to my clients, I ask them, think of two people that you can go and contact about this thing and ask them, what did you do when you felt this way? Or what did you do when you were stuck in this manner? And that might actually help you get out of your head and into solutions, right? So, and out of the procrastination also, because you're already moving towards the goal by trying to solve this problem of procrastination. So set a schedule, you work at this time, and so you don't go on social media. So allocate social media time, allocate time, reward yourself with certain things, like the things that you enjoy more. And also prioritize, firstly, the things that are most important, the things that you enjoy in your day. So that's another step that you can do, is that prioritize the things that you actually enjoy doing, start your day with things that you don't enjoy. That is what will actually help you procrastinate, because if you're going to start your day with something that, or tell yourself you're going to start your day by doing something that you actually don't enjoy, you're already demotivated in the morning. So start your day with something that is actually that you enjoy, so that you're alive, and work during the hours where you're actually really, really, really awake, and get things done, and then move on to rewarding yourself. So set the schedule up, prioritize according to what you enjoy, and prioritize also according to what is most important. And don't forget to schedule also the rest, because that's also a big part of that, is that if you're constantly overwhelming yourself with the things that you need to do that you actually might not as enjoy as much as resting, social media, or whatever else it is that you want to do, then start your day with the things that you actually do enjoy. All right, that's it from me, Yvette Ratshikhopha, life coach, author, and entrepreneur. And yeah, I hope this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments if you found it helpful, which tip was the most useful for you. And I am sending you love where you are. Until next time, trust the process.